Tradition long overdue. Whoever said the Korean War was not a war called it many things. They called it a police action. Well, we know better. We also know firsthand that war is ugly. It was called in Scripture the last and last resort. A king in ancient Israel had to handwrite his own copy of the Bible and carry it with him on his person at all times. Why do you think that was? To keep him from thinking he was God. To keep him from thinking, as a commander-in-chief, that he could declare war for the wrong reasons. We have enough people in this world already doing that. So God bless those who remember the truth. And the difference between South Korea and North Korea is more than merely a number of latitude. It is a world of difference between peace and warmongering, between human rights and deprivation of those rights. If common sense were truly common, it wouldn't be so precious. If human rights were universal, oh, this world would be such a better place. That's why we pray. Dear God, bless these veterans who served in difficult and challenging times, who remember faith, family, freedom. Help us to serve you with clean hands and pure hearts. Let us remember to honor those who made the supreme sacrifice for the worthiness of our cause. And may each war bring an end to all wars. And let us say together, amen.
Amen. Amen. Good morning, all. Good morning again. How about another round of applause for the Travis Air Force Base Band of the Golden West intact. Amazing so far. Thank you all so much. We want to thank Rabbi. Rabbi had another engagement, so that's why we did our invocation a little early. He wanted to make sure that he saw you all and shared his always meaningful and poignant words. So we are going to start our ceremony, folks. We're all here to honor you today, our Korean War veterans. So please give yourselves a round of applause. We are so thankful to be able to celebrate this day with all of you. Some wonderful representatives, Consul General is here. It's just such a special day. So with that being said, please present the colors.
Stand by. Ho! Tinge. Hoi! Horse. 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 Present Harms.
Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Colors! Colors, sir! Hearts!
Because it came between two major conflicts. It came between World War II, Vietnam, and then the Cold War. And I spent some time, what was it, a month or so ago, or a couple months, I don't know, time all comes together, honoring the Vietnam veterans who were poorly recognized when they came back. But you folks didn't receive a lot either, because it was the political climate was a little different. You didn't receive a poor reception like the Vietnam veterans did, but still it wasn't a celebratory kind of recognition like World War I and World War II, and then even our veterans coming home now from conflict. So for that, I apologize, and but I salute you as the heroes that you are. So I want to give you some numbers today. For the veterans home, right now our biggest population is Vietnam veterans. That has changed significantly since all of you have come in here. Right now we only have 81 Korean War veterans here now. And some of those veterans served in multiple conflicts, but I'm highlighting the ones that were specifically in Korea. 32 Army. Show me your hands if you're Army. What? Go Army. Okay. 26 Air Force. There you go. Okay. All right. 17 Navy. Okay. 6 Marines. Okay. We won't hold that against anybody. So, and then we have 4 female veterans. And you know what happens? How many? Do we have any female veterans in here besides myself? Stephanie. Okay, what happens a lot is somebody will go, you can have a couple sitting at a table, and somebody will go to the man and say, where did you serve? And totally avoid the woman, not even considering that she served. So keep that in the back of your mind, especially on this campus. We have quite a few female veterans who did serve, and a lot of them will not stand up and say, I served, because they minimize their service. So thank you, any female veterans out there. One of the comments that I saw posted today from one of our veterans in the Ventura home, he was quoted as saying, regarding the Forgotten War, he goes, well, it wasn't forgotten by those who fought, wasn't forgotten by those who suffered. They had wounds, they lost buddies, or they lost loved ones. It's very much real. For all of them, for all of you. And then I want to say something about the Korean War Memorial in D.C. How many of you have been there to see it? Who hasn't been there to see it? If you haven't seen it, it'll touch you right down to your soul. It's an amazing, amazing memorial, especially if you see it on a day where it's kind of wet and the rain is in front of you. It's just amazing. Because this war was fought in the hottest of hot and the coldest of cold. The troops, I always say soldiers, but I don't mean it. I mean troops. The troops that fought in that war suffered. They suffered through the elements. They suffered from being away from home, from being away from their families, and their families suffered because they weren't able to get a hold of just, I mean, today we have the internet, we have FaceTime and all these other things. You all had to wait for a letter. And then your families had to wait for a letter, and they had to go on without you. So thank you. Thank you so much for your service and for that. And happy anniversary. Thank you.
Here in San Francisco. I came here 2.5 years ago in November 2020. And normally when I arrive in a new post, I reach out to meet people, but it was in the middle of pandemic, so I couldn't get here. So I'm very sorry about that, but it's my first time to be here. I really think that this the Yountville, the Petra home, is a very wonderful place to live for the many veterans here. Connor Lisa Peak, the home administrator of Veteran Home of the California Yountville, and Korean veterans and family member, it is my great pleasure to make a remarks on the occasion of commemoration of 70th anniversary of military armistice agreement, which was made back in 1953 on the same day, July 27th. First of all, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to CARVET and the Veteran Home of the Yountville for organizing this memorable event with the presence of many Korean veterans. My special thanks also go to Colonel Nesta Liga, who has done a lot for Korean War veterans here. This thing is just on June 25th, 1950, the North Korean Communist Army crossed the borderline, the 38th parallel, and attacked South Korea, threatening the very survival of the Republic of Korea. When the war broke out, the millions of American men and women in total came to Korean Peninsula to defend the freedom and democracy of the Republic of Korea at the time. Without U.S. servicemen and women's noble sacrifice and the courageous heroism, Republic of Korea could not survive and could not defend our freedom and democracy. So now the Republic of Korea became one of the largest economy, 10th largest economy around the world, with vibrant democracies. And also Korea became a very true friend to the United States. On behalf of the government of Republic of Korea on this occasion, I'd like to express our sincere appreciation to all the Korean veterans who are present here today for their noble sacrifice during the Korean War. And you know, the in Korean War Memorial in Washington, D.C., you can find the inscription that is, freedom is not free. So because of your heroism, your dedication during the war, Korea become free now. After 3 years of intense battle, war has ended, and our two nations signed a mutual defense treaty and opened a new era of alliance. So after the Korean War, in October 1st, the Korea and U.S. Agreed upon to have a mutual defense agreement. And this agreement has been the basis for peace and security for Korean Peninsula over 7 decades. So that means that today is the 70th anniversary of the U.S. at the Korean War Armistice, But at the same time, this year marked 70th anniversary of Korea-U.S. alliance back in 1953. And 3 months ago, Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol and President Biden had a summit meeting in Washington, D.C. at the White House and decided to significantly strengthen extended deterrence of our two countries against North Korea, so nuclear and missile threat, by adopting the Washington Declaration. So as you know, the North Korea has been always a problem to Korea and the United States by making a nuclear bomb and testing the missiles. Right now they are launching the intercontinental ICBM missiles that can reach to every city in the United States. So that is a real concern for our two countries, and the two leaders agreed upon the Washington Declaration that is focusing on the mutual enforcement of capability of bilateral alliances, extended deterrence. So by deploying the submarine, ballistic missile submarines, or all kind of capability provided by the United States. So, and at the same time, two leaders agreed upon further strengthening the strategic partnership in technology and economic security. As you know, Korea is becoming a very important trading partner to the United States. So, in case of California, Korea is the number fourth major trading partner to California right now. And you know, in Silicon Valley, there are many Korean companies who has a big name, like Samsung, Hyundai, LG has a big presence in the Silicon Valley. And now Korean startups are moving to Silicon Valley to establish their own business here. So I think we will have a much more closer relation in science and technology, and also the very important technological sectors. So having said that, they are saying that the Korean War is the forgotten war, something like that. But we Koreans are always grateful, and we don't forget any time the Korean War. It is a real thing, and still we have a big impact of the Korean War's outcome. And I think the noble legacy made by Korean War veterans will be remembered and over the generations. And we Koreans are always grateful for the noble sacrifice and noble service by the U.S. servicemen and women. And that is the basis for our strengthened cooperation, strengthened alliance over the 7 decades. And also we are looking forward to moving forward because Korea is a true alliance to the United States, and we would like to do work together with the U.S. government to address the many challenges we are facing today around the world. Thank you very much. Thank you. One more thing, we would like to provide a certificate of appreciation today, and I would like to read the paragraph of the award. In commemoration of 70th anniversary of Korean War, Armistice and Korea-U.S. Alliance, it is a great honor and pleasure to express our deepest appreciation of and our people for the service that you and your countrymen have performed in restoring and preserving the freedom and democracy. So we cherish in our heart the memory of your noble sacrifice in assisting us to rebuild our freedom, and we look forward to your continued support for strengthening our alliance. Presented on 27 July 2023 and carried back to home, Yountville, California, by the Korean representative, Sang Soo-yoon, Consul General of Republic of Korea in San Francisco. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Luca Moretti with Congressman Mike Thompson's office. I want to say, first of all, the Congressman is incredibly saddened he cannot be here today. Currently, work has him in D.C. He's likely voting on the floor of the U.S. House right now. So, other than that, he would love to be here presenting and recognizing all of you for your sacrifice and service to our country. I want to, first of all, thank the Consul General. I want to thank Nestor Aliga for helping putting this together. And I also want to thank the administrator of the Veterans Home for all she does for veterans, Lisa Peek. And finally, want to recognize each veteran in the room today who sacrificed and served in Korea. You didn't just protect the values of this nation and protect American democracy. You sacrificed so much to ensure another country, Korea, could have the same democratic values that we hold dear and have the same ability and pursuit of liberty that we have in this country. Your sacrifices have meant that millions of people can live in the same freedom we enjoy today. And I want to thank you for all your service and recognize the 70th anniversary of the Korean War Armistice. Today, I'm pleased to present on behalf of Congressman Thompson the following certificate. In recognition of your service to our country on today, the 70th anniversary of the Korean War Armistice, thank you so much. Now I want to bring up Alex Pater with Bill Dotts.
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me. Alex Pater here on behalf of Senator Bill Dotts. Also a Senate member, Cecilia Aguiar Curry. Unfortunately, couldn't be here today, but also wanted to make sure that we thank you all for your service. Thank you to the General Consulate for being here. Thank you to our Colonel Nestor Barriga for all his work on veterans and for helping organize today. And also thank you to the Veterans Home and Lisa Peek for hosting us today. We have a certificate for each of you as well. 70th anniversary of the Korean War Armistice. In recognition of your steadfast commitment, devotion, and invaluable efforts in the armed forces of the United States of America during the Korean War, and for your commitment, leadership, dedication, and substantial contributions with preserving the American way of life. So again, on behalf of Senator Bill Dodd and the Assembly Member Cecilia Curry, thank you very much, and thank you for having us today.
Thank you again to all of our wonderful presenters. At this time, folks, those certificates they mentioned, we would love, we're gonna call each person who's in attendance today, one by one. We've asked you to come up. We're gonna have a photo opportunity with Consul General, our representatives, Administrator Peek, and you'll see those certificates and get a photo with all of them to commemorate the day. So we'll start that now. Edward Burke. And if anyone doesn't feel like coming up, that's totally fine as well. Just wave your hand and let us know, and we'll make sure to get your certificate to you.
Kenneth Clark. Ken. Oh, all right. Ken's going to hold
it. I told him.
Joseph Clary.
Three, two, one,
more, three, two, one. Don Elsa.
3, 2, 1.
John Blue. John, would you raise your hand one more time? We'll take it forever to you. Thank you, John. Thank you, Thomas. We'll get you your certificates. Is it John Schulte? Schulte. Schulte. I'm sorry, John Schulte.
They're gonna make sure they get
Again, we can't thank you all enough. This was such a wonderful day. We hope you had a meaningful time, and we'll see you. We'll see you next time. Thank you all.